Ladies and gentlemen, the moment you've all been waiting for, Crown of Thoughts, my record collection. I'm going to try to make a series and go through like all of it, I guess, except the shitty ones. I'm going to start off with just the 7 inches here to get used to the concept of it, I suppose. I'm going to start you guys off with one that I enjoy thoroughly and play a lot. This is Turnstile Step 2 Rhythm. And you can see the back here. And so what we got with this one, pull this fucker out, is, and I got this color, had a bunch of colors. This is the one I got, and I really like it. And when we open this guy up, we have basically this little paper here that it comes with. All this cool craziness, Turnstile, all the lyrics, all the nonsense. There we go. There's that one. Next here we have a tribute to Kill Your Idols. As you can see, Bullet Treatment, Offsides, Backtrack, Rust, Belt Lights, Seasick, and Violent Society covering these songs. Pretty good mix there. We'll open this guy up and see what we got. This is like, I think, for a free download of the album, something like that. We got this little thing that opens up here, blah, 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 good shit. And it's a black vinyl here. We got Kill Your Idols tribute, ladies and gentlemen. And that's that one. Next here we have Neon Nazis. Hips Take Me Off Your Playlist. I don't know if they're talking about hipsters or what they're talking about. And this is like an old, you know, one of these deals. So that's pretty cool. We got there, Neon Nazis. And next here we have Inside Out. And that is an old hardcore band that is the lead singer of Rage Against the Machine there. They only made this one album. This one got 4 songs, I think. The full one has like 6 tracks on it. If I could figure out how to open this and show you guys what it is like. It is like this, a clear green vinyl. Other side, like that. And the pamphlet here that we have looks like this, basically. Blah, blah, blah. Got all the lyrics and everything set up that way, man. Flipping through this collection. Here we got Hatebreed, Under the Knife. It's like their first ever, their demo that they made. Looks like that. Dude jumping up and down on the back. Of course, because it's Hatebreed. And here we got this pamphlet like that. Yeah, right there. It looks good. And it looks like that. A cool little fucker that we got here. Hatebreed, Under the Knife. I'm having trouble figuring out how to hold this stuff. It's fucking with my head. And so there's that one, ladies and gentlemen. And here we got some a lot of these I just kind of picked up. And like this, I don't know how to fucking pronounce all that shit. Anti-Nazi, the title of the album. And there's on the back, I can barely even pronounce the fucking band's name. And what do we have here? It's like this, 83 Hardcore. That's the fucking band name there. So good stuff. Now, next, what we have here would be Discharge, everybody. Discharge. There's the back of it. Good stuff. Good stuff. Y'all gotta like this band. They created a fucking army of bands that copy them and even use the same fucking font for the logo and all that. So, Discharge, everybody. Get this figured out here. And there we go. That's the fucking record right there. So that was Discharge, everybody. And now we've got someone you guys probably all know and adore for his wonderful attitude, G.G. Allin. Oh, yeah. Yup, G.G. Allen, everybody. He's got like fucking two songs, of course, and then interviews like he always does. So this just kind of folds out like that, you know, blah, 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 blah. And then here we got the fucking record, everybody. G.G. Allen and the Jabbers, I believe. I'm not even reading these titles for you guys. For those who can take it raw, G.G. Allen and the Jabbers. Cool stuff, ladies and gentlemen. Now we got something. I got this at a local show around here. There's a lot of good local bands. Crystal Methodist, Stop Loss, Shitty Friends, and Old Tigers. Old Tigers is obviously like our hometown heroes. But it's like a split between these guys, as you can see on the back. And if I can open it, we'll see. There's the record. And anything cool in here? Not particularly any extra goodies in here, but that's a bunch of local bands. Really good shit there. So here we go, gonna keep continuing here. I'm actually editing and stopping this. I'm gonna see what it looks like. If it looks like shit, I'll just fucking redo it. This is a band that I grew up loving. These guys is Quicksand, awesome. This is like their demo, their first thing they did. And then these songs basically appear on the first album, except for the one. What's it called? Hypno Jam with Dan and Unfulfilled, I think those songs are not on the other one that came out right after it. There we got this guy. And on the inside, all this good stuff. So, and then here we have the actual record for you guys. Next. Back here again. Chopping this up, editing it. Hive Lords, this is a local black metal band. Really good. Really good shit. I got this. I have a full album of theirs. And then they gave me this just for buying it, because local bands are cool like that. They like their fans. They like their fans here. The Hive Lords. The almighty Hive Lords, ladies and gentlemen. We got any goodies inside of here? Not particularly. Local band Hive Lords. Good black metal, the depressing kind, I guess. Where the guy's like screaming and shrieking and it sounds like he wants to fucking die. That type of shit. So, next. So here we go again. These fucking, like I said, a lot of these I just ended up buying all in this one bin. And this is another one I showed you it. I don't know how to pronounce that name of them guys. And here's the vinyl here, and that's pretty cool stuff here. And what else we got? This album, The Prosthetics, man. Pretty good. I never heard of a lot of these before buying them, so I went home, banged all this shit out, man. It's pretty cool. Pretty cool, yeah. There we go. Good stuff. And of course, Weird Al Yankovic, like a surgeon. I loved Weird Al Yankovic when I was growing up. It's just a standard black vinyl. And so that was really cool. Really cool to buy here. Moving along here, Orangutang. And this one is pretty, pretty cool, man. That's a pretty cool album cover right there. Orangutan. And how does this guy look? Looks like this, man. Not too shabby of an album. Now we got the Sensational Octopus compilation here. And it looks like this. And you know, we got this guy like that, man. Interesting find. Any goodies in good here? It looks like we got some goodies, man. order here. I feel like a teacher in elementary when they're reading a book and then they show the... They turn the page and show the class the fucking picture. Yeah, there we go, man. Next, moving right along, and we've got this guy. This guy right here, man. Let's see what kind of stuff we got inside here. So look at it. There's the fucking record. Pretty cool. Pretty cool guy. Anything else? Anything else? Nope, not particularly. There's another one. Another one in the fucking bag. Whatever. Interesting find here. I don't have a lot to say about it. Other than I listened to it and it's pretty cool. Pretty interesting. There's the vinyl there for you, standard black. Here we got House Plants. Never heard of House Plants, you probably haven't either. Red Circus Records. And that's not a bad one. I took a listen and Regulations, Different Needs EP right here. Regulations. Pretty cool album cover. There's some inside stuff to look at. This in particular is pretty cool. Little thing there. Inside. And then here we go. The record itself. Good stuff. Moving right along now. This here is another one of those like weird, don't know how I came across it type of abstract fucking and records. It sounds good. I listened to it and I like it. But I don't have a lot to say about it because a lot of this stuff is shit I don't really know too much about or didn't to begin with. But not this. This here. I bought this at the Napalm Death show. But if you've ever heard of Melt Banana, it's like a split between Napalm Death and Melt Banana, which is crazy insane. It's a fucking awesome concept to me, and I'm really happy to have this one in my collection here. There's that, and we'll get to the actual vinyl in a second. Napalm Death, Melt Banana. Amazing. Amazing record. And here's the last one. And I don't know anything about this. You can look at it like here. And it's actually really, really cool. I played it. Trust me, guys. Go out and buy it now. Although I don't think that you'll find it anywhere. Because it's one of them real abstract. Hard to find, like random finds. It's what a lot of these 7 inches are for me. You know. And so that's it, man. That is my 7-inch collection. And I'm basically just trying to figure out how to do this, get used to the concept. This is like the intro to my collection. And I'm not sure how it's going to look. I did editing just now, like pausing and shit. I don't normally do that. So I'm pretty anxious to see how it looks and to go through my entire collection in various episodes. I'll try to figure out how to do it to where it's actually entertaining. And it's not like I'm like off the wall bands, but like I'm going to try to do it by genres and stuff like that. Keep it by genres. You can't necessarily always do that because not all bands fall into a particular genre, but I can do my best. So Crown of Thoughts here, double A, and I'm just getting you guys ready because everyone's asking for it. I want to see your entire fucking collection, man. I can't take it no more. I want to hear what you're listening to at the house. I want to come up I want to come up and play it while you're fucking sleeping before you wake up in the morning. It's like that. So I'm like, guys, chill. I'll fucking do it already. So that's it, man. I'm in a, an interesting fucking half awake mood here, and I wanted to see how to do this, and I think it's gonna turn out pretty good. And I think I just showed you guys a lot of good records, and this is only the beginning. There's shit. This isn't even the beginning, man. I guess it is the beginning. It kind of has to be. But I'm gonna fucking go now, and you guys are gonna sit back and think, and you'll be starving for the rest of my collection. So this is Double A, Crown of Thoughts. I'll be doing whatever I want, more shit coming, more guests. Man, whatever I feel like doing. And so you guys have a good one, and I'll try to do the same.